Hello everyone, and welcome back to our inventory system series in Godot 4. This is the last part of our system, and to wrap things off, we will create a spawning system, an item spawning system.
I lied, as I have from the very beginning.
We will finally get to add some code to our main scene and our main script, which we created way, way back and never even touched. So let's open up our main scene and get started. First off, I'm going to delete any item instances that I've added here. Then, to our main scene, we need to add two new nodes. The first node that we need to add is a node 2D node that will organize all of our spawned items. Rename this node to items. The other node that we need to add is an area 2D node, which we will rename to item spawn area. This area 2D node will contain a collision shape that will define where we want our items to spawn on our map. We'll usually do something like this with a tile map instead of an area 2D node, but because I know a lot of people struggle with tile maps because it's so vast and so complex, I didn't want to overcomplicate things. I just want to show you a quick and easy way to spawn items in a certain area on your map. So let's add a collision shape to our item spawn area where our items will spawn on our map. Now this collision shape needs to be a rectangle, so let's give it a shape of a rectangle. We also need to change the extent of my rectangle to be the size of the area that we want the items to spawn in. I'm going to make mine 500 by 500, and then I will drag my area 2D node to where I want my items to spawn. Make sure to drag the area 2D node and not the collision shape 2D node to where you want your items to spawn, because otherwise your spawning will be off. This is where I want my items to spawn and the radius of the spawn area that I want. So make sure you make something similar to this on your map. Next, we'll have to define an array of items that we might want to spawn when we load the game. Because up until now, we've added the details to the item in the inspector panel itself, but our game can't do that. So we'll need to create an array of predefined items that the game can choose from to spawn. These items shouldn't be any unique item, it should be an item that's pretty common, like a consumable or a gift or anything that you could run around the corner and find. It shouldn't necessarily be quest items because our spawner might create duplicates of this item, so when it's spawning items, it's going to make 5 apples and 10 quest items of the same type because it's in the array and it's just randomly choosing what to put in this spawn area. With that being said, let's head back to our global script and define an array of items with set properties that we might like to spawn on load. As you can see, I already had a list that I just pasted in here because I honestly didn't want to type all that. But each item has a type, a name, an effect, and a texture that you need to make sure that the path is valid. Remember, if you don't want your item to have an effect, you can just leave it empty. Now, back in our main script, let's create a node reference to each of our newly added nodes. So our items, item spawn area, and collision shape 2D node. We'll have to get a random position within our spawn area shape to spawn our items on. So let's create a function that will return a random position for us. We'll start by getting the bounds of our collision shape via the getRect method. We'll then get a random X and Y position within these boundaries using the built-in random float value generator. Finally, we will return these X and Y coordinates as a vector 2 value. We'll have to convert this value to a global position to make the spawned item's position relative to the position of the spawn area. So basically, we need to spawn the item within the collision shape. Next, we'll have to create a function that will loop over our global spawnable items array and spawn the items until we've spawned X amount of them. So say on load, we say we want to spawn 10 items. This function will then loop through the array up until it has spawned 10 items, the 10 items that we asked for. If we don't have 10 items in our array, it will reuse items, hence causing duplication. The count parameter that we passed into this function is the number of items that we want to spawn. We'll have to keep track of the number of attempts and items that it tried to create, so we'll create variables that will keep track of these values. We'll then use a while loop to attempt spawning until either the desired number of items have been reached or a maximum number of attempts, which we'll set to a value such as 100, has been made. To actually spawn an item, we need to first go and create a custom function which will spawn an individual item. Before we create our new custom function, we actually need to go back to our inventory item component and add a new function which will set the item's properties dynamically, which will allow us to spawn our items with different characteristics. Now back in our main scene, we can create our new function which will initiate the item properties and spawn an item from our item scene. We'll spawn it underneath our items node that we added to our main scene tree. Now we can call this function in our spawn random items function. We'll select a random item from an array and assign it to the random position. Finally, we will call this function in our ready function of our main script to spawn a certain amount of items when we run the game. I'm going to spawn 10 items on game load. So, just to recap, our getRandomPosition function gets a random position for our item that we want to spawn within the spawn area. Our spawnItem function spawns an individual item. The item that is spawned is determined by the spawnRandomItems function that randomly chooses an item from our list, and its position is determined by our getRandomPosition return value. Finally, we call our spawnRandomItems with the amount of items that we want to spawn when we run the game in our ready function. Now, if you run your scene, your items should be spawned. There should be 10 items here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, there are 10 items that have spawned in my spawn area. And also, if you do instance the items manually, you should still be able to interact with them and add it to your inventory and be able to drop it. So whether you do it via the spawner or via manual instancing, it should still work and your inventory should still be usable. I'd love to hear more about your projects that you're busy working with and also your learning experience with this series. I also just wanted to say that I am in the process of currently turning all of my written PDF tutorials, such as my 2D RPG, 2D platformer, and my procedural generation games that are all written tutorials, into video format. So those will also be video tutorials. So yeah, I have a lot planned for the next upcoming months and a Discord and I'll keep you in the loop. But for now, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the future.